Welcome to our online chemistry class. Our topic is alcohols, phenols and ether. So in today's lecture we'll discuss methods of preparation of phenol. So first method is from chlorobenzene and the process is Dow's process. So when chlorobenzene is fused with alkali such as NaOH at high temperature and pressure. So here temperature and pressure is given as 623 Kelvin and 150 atm, but in old syllabus the temperature is 613 Kelvin and pressure is 300 atmospheric pressure. So we have to confirm it. So we'll give detail about the change, whether which one is correct, that we'll discuss later on. Okay, but for a while you can remember 613 and pressure is 300 atmospheric pressure. So when chlorobenzene is treated with this alkali at such a high temperature and pressure, then so similar to your alkyl halide, the Cl directly does not replace by OH because aromatic compounds are less reactive than aliphatic compounds or alkyl halide. So first it gives, so this O minus will attack on this O minus, ONa will attack here and we get C6H5ONa, and that Na from another molecule react with Cl gives NaCl, and two hydrogen one oxygen gives H2O, and oxygen is along with Na. So we get a intermediate, and it is the sodium and this is C6H5O, so it is phenoxide ion. So intermediate is sodium phenoxide, and then this react with dilute HCl. Then you can break the bond between ONa like this. Hydrogen is added to oxygen to give OH. Na react with Cl gives NaCl. So this balancing is not given in your textbook, but while writing the reaction in your exam, always write down the balance equation. So for balancing purpose, in the first step, so write down two step, and sodium phenoxide plus NaCl plus H2, and then again take sodium phenoxide and react with HCl, dilute HCl gives phenol plus NaCl. Or if you write in single step, then write down like this. Minus NaCl and minus H2O on first arrow and NaCl here. So this is about the first reaction. So as your chlorobenzene is less reactive than aryl chloride, we have to use strong alkali NaOH, and first we get sodium phenoxide. Don't directly write down chlorobenzene to phenol product by reacting with NaOH, like your Rx plus NaOH gives ROH plus NaCl or NaX. So remember this step, intermediate, and we have to keep the temperature high and pressure high. So don't forget to write the temperature and process, temperature and pressure. Remember this, the name is Dow's process. Process is Dow's process. And next is from cumin. So this is the commercial method of preparation of phenol. So cumin means this CH3CH. This group is called as isopropyl group, and this group replaces the hydrogen from benzene. So the another name of cumin is isopropyl benzene. It react with air or oxygen. From that air, so the name of the reaction is air oxidation. Reaction takes place in presence of cobalt naphthenate as a catalyst at temperature 423 Kelvin in presence of alkaline medium. What is the alkaline medium? It is Na2CO3, etc. Means your medium should be alkaline. And then this oxygen is added in between this carbon and hydrogen. So what do we get? Remaining things are as it is, CH3 twice C O single bond O single bond H. So I think all are familiar with the peroxide H2O2. So similar to that, this peroxide is obtained, and it is a peroxide of cumin, so name is cumin peroxide. Then there is a rearrangement. So this O will attack on this sp2 carbon of benzene ring, and the bond between this carbon, sp2 carbon of benzene ring, and this carbon gets shifted to C double bond O. So there is a double bond between this C and O, and it gives CH3 C double bond O CH3. OH is attached to this benzene ring carbon. So we get a phenol and acetone as a product when cumene hydroperoxide react with dilute. So this is the good method for preparation of phenol, because along with this, acetone is the byproduct which is more important and it's not wasted. So this is a commercial method for preparation of cumene. So many time question may be asked in your exam. Write down the commercial method of preparation of cumene. So write down method of preparation of phenol. So cumin word is not mentioned, so you have to write same reaction, and this reaction may be asked for 2 marks. Then next is from benzene sulfonic acid. So the benzene sulfonic, so the hydrogen of benzene ring get replaced by SO3H group, that is sulfonic acid group. So we already discussed the preparation of benzene sulfonic acid from benzene in your 11th standard. So this benzene sulfonic acid on a react, it is an acid, react with alkali like NaOH. So name of the reaction is neutralization. So H get replaced by Na. So this H and this OH gives H2O. This HOH gives H2O, and O Na get attached to SO3. So SO3 is negatively charged, Na is positively charged. So it is a salt. Acid react with alkali gives salt and water. So name of the salt is sodium benzene sulfonate. Sodium benzene sulfonate. And then this sodium benzene sulfonate fused with excess of NaOH. So that's why I write down 2 moles at 573 Kelvin. There is a correction. And replace the SO3 Na group by ONa group. So what is the byproduct? Byproduct is that Na react with SO3 and we get Na2SO3, because SO3 is 2 minus and Na is 1 plus. So Na2SO3 and water is the byproduct, and we get sodium phenoxide. And in previous step, we already know how to convert the sodium phenoxide to phenol. Simply treat it with dilute HCl gives phenol plus NaCl. So this step is here is that you already learn. You simply have to remember, first step is neutralization to give sodium benzene sulfonate, and second step is fusion to give sodium peroxide. In both steps, we have to use NaOH. But remember the balance in the equation. So byproducts are written on arrow. If write single step reaction, you can write three separate steps. This is about the preparation of phenol from benzene sulfonic acid. Then next one is from aniline. So aniline, NH2 group is attached to benzene ring carbon, so it is a primary aromatic amine. So remember that only primary aromatic amine such as aniline or aminobenzene, another name is aminobenzene, shows this reaction, and the name of the reaction is diazotization. Only primary amine, whether it is aromatic or aliphatic, shows diazotization reaction. So this is important point from the CET exam. So let us see the reaction. So what is the reagent? NaNO2 and HCl. NaNO2 means sodium nitrite, NO2 is nitrite, NO3 is nitrate. NaNO2 react with HCl gives HNO2, nitrous acid, and HNO3 is nitric acid plus NaCl. So formation of nitrous acid. So reagent is NaNO2 and HCl. So you can write that reagent on arrow, and HNO2 react with aniline with HCl, or you can write NaNO2 plus 2HCl directly, so that also react with aniline to give benzene diazonium chloride. So how you write this product? So this hydrogen from NH2 group react with oxygen O2 from HNO2, and it gives byproduct 2H2, and this nitrogen is added with this nitrogen, so it gives N2 plus that with balance with Cl minus from HCl. So this is benzene ring, and N2 group dash N triple bond N, it is azo group, so it is benzene diazonium chloride. And this diazonium chloride has, benzene diazonium chloride has much more importance in organic synthesis. If it react with water, it gives, on heating the mixture, we get phenol as a product. So there are different uses of benzene diazonium chloride that you observe while learning the topic number 13. Okay, here one of the uses, preparation of phenol. So what is the byproduct? N2 gas is evolved, and HCl is the another byproduct. So these are the four method of preparation of phenol. So many time question may be asked on method of preparation of this phenol in your board exam. So just I'll revise. First is from chlorobenzene by Dodds process, and second is from cumene, it is commercial method, reagent is oxygen in presence of cobalt naphthenate, and then you have to add diluted Cl. Third is from benzene sulfonic acid. There are two steps in which NOH is used, and last step is action of diluted Cl, and last reaction is from aniline by diazotization. NaNO2 and HCl is the reagent. So this is about the methods of preparation of phenol.